Okay, hello and welcome, guys, to the second episode of Northern Hauling. Today it's Friday still. We took a nap after our last delivery there, and it's 9 o'clock at night. It's raining, and we're just about to pick up our trailer there. We don't know what's in it because, as you can see, I can't read whatever language that is. So, I think it's Russian, I'm not sure. We're gonna pick up that trailer, and we're gonna bring it to Copenhagen at Polar Logistics. So let's do it. The air brake off, huh? Gonna hook up to our trailer first. I'll try to get the sound working a little better for the video. I think it should be good now. I know in the first two videos you could barely hear the game sounds at all. Alright, let's hook up to our trailer. Here we have it. So we're all hooked up. We are towing about 44,000 pounds. Well, let's get on our way then. This truck looks really good with that trailer. Alright, and here we go. This will be our second trip as a trucking company. In our first trip, we basically proved that those grocery store drops in the new DLC are not impossible to do. We did them, and we were using an oversized truck, so I don't know. I guess some people just don't think out of think the situation through there. This will probably be a two-part video. Or probably not. We only got 132 kilometers. We're probably just gonna make it a single video. It's not that far of a trip, so. And it sucks that it's raining. I mean, I guess it's gotta rain sometime. I got the rain probability set very low. I like the realism of actually having some rain in the game. It doesn't make sense when there's no rain at all. Oh, these on-ramps are tricky when you're driving a American truck. Try not to hit your trailer off the rails there. You managed it, of course. I It looks like we're hitting the highway. Check our map for a second. Yeah, it looks like we're going to be riding this highway all the way to Copenhagen. So that's beautiful. Be a nice short trip. Because we're going to be going... Speed limit's going to be 80 on the highway, but we're going to run about 85. So... Should be a nice quick trip. Let's get it done. Again, we're in the Kenworth T800. It's we're running a 710 horsepower engine, and it pulls this shit just fine, doesn't it? All right, we're gonna run about 86 kilometers on the cruise control here. What a shitty day here in we're in Poland. I'm really bad with my European maps here. Let's see. Oh, I'm not too sure actually. Oh well, well. We know we're in the north of Europe. At least we know that. Oh! Jesus Christ! Took that corner a little wide there. Gotta be careful. I was changing this thing here, not paying attention to the road. So we didn't get in a wreck. There'd probably be some real nice scenery if it wasn't 10 o'clock at night and raining. Too bad, we'll have to run through here in another video when it's daytime. Is there like a lighthouse or something there? That's cool. There's the van I hit. Sorry, bud. Just so you guys know, I'm using the keyboard and mouse for the controls. I'd like to get a G27 steering wheel, but they're very expensive, so that's the main thing. They introduced a new thing into the game. It's like an easy pass. Watch, I'll just drive through here and I'll be charged. I don't have to stop, I don't have to wait. Very cool. $234. Or euros. Quen, as they say. Is that what they say, Quen? $234 Quen? Quid? I don't know. Yeah, that's pretty cool. That'll be great for some of the oversized long trailer mods. Because I remember the people used to get their trailer stuck because the gate would come down on their trailer when they're driving, and that would be the end of the trip. So that would suck. After half an hour being in a trip, and then they get to a toll, and then it comes down and fucks their whole day up. So, we're almost there, actually, guys. We got about 40 kilometers to go. We're gonna see what kind of drop off we got. Like I said in the last video, I really like what SCS is doing with the more difficult drops. They're a lot more realistic. I think they should go through the whole map and change the old stuff because it's. You guys are probably with me on this. It's not great. It's not fantastic at all. So the new ones are just phenomenal, though. What's going on here? Do I have an automatic retarder in this truck? Let's check. Is that? Do I have automatic retarder working right now? No. Oh, I have a speed limiter, that's okay. Huh. Just trying to figure out what that little green light coming out of my dash when I was going down those hills. And right there. It's weird. Here's our exit. Oh, I know this truck does actually have a retarder. With this gearbox. I think the truck's automatically using the retarder. I have it set on off, but that's the symbol that comes up. Strange. Looks like it stopped raining. I don't know how long ago it did. I just didn't notice, I guess. Left my wipers on. It looks a lot better than it stopped raining, I guess. Where are we going anyway? Polar Logistics. Should just be up here. another Maxi Foods. We are Polar Logistics. That's no good. Oh! Oopsies. Better watch where I'm going, Jesus. We have it. All right, guys. Thanks for watching.